What do we want?
Better memory.
When do we want it?
What?
Joking aside, I have a 2 terabyte hard disk and used to think that's a lot. Then I bought a new video camera and it's clocked my disk in no time. And yes, there's cloud storage, but you know, it's not actually in the clouds. They still store it on something down on Earth. And besides that, it'd take me forever to upload. So I was thrilled to see this recent paper in Nature about a new optical storage method that could bring disk memory into the petabyte range. Petabytes. That's 1,000 terabytes. Let's have a look. The new technology is an old technology. It's optical storage. Some of you may even be old enough to remember optical storage. We used to carry music around on those things called compact discs. And let me just say, you had to walk very carefully if you didn't want to listen to the same sentence 1,000 times. Later, we put movies on these things called DVDs. We now have a neighbor who's hung her old DVDs up on the balcony to scare off the pigeons. True story. These compact discs were usually made of some kind of plastic with a coating which gave them their shiny appearance. They worked by using a laser to burn the information into the coating and then read it out again. Actually, a pretty nice idea, quite straightforward. Why did compact discs die? They were outcompeted by hard drives that can store information packed much more densely. The information density on compact discs or any optical storage is ultimately limited by the frequency of the laser light. For visible light, that's a few hundred nanometers. In modern flash drives, the information is stored in little magnetizable cells that are just a few atoms in size and can be as small as 10 nanometers or so. They can store much more data in the same space, hence the death of compact discs. But maybe they'll soon make a comeback, because in this new work, a group of researchers from China figured out how to write data in multiple layers on a disk with lasers and read them out again. They say this could work up to hundreds of layers, which would be a huge increase in memory capacity. They say that a single disk of this type could store as much as a petabit. Yes, a bit isn't the same as a byte, but then this was only a prototype. They also envisioned that in data centers, the disks could be stacked into arrays that could each hold exabits. Sounds good, but just exactly what did they do? This new work is really a combination of several advances. Partly, they made it work because they have a synthetic material that can be modified in a very targeted way by changing how its polymers are linked. They can write at a certain depth in the material by focusing the laser on one particular spot. They actually use 2 lasers, one that initiates a change of the molecular property of the disk and the second that terminates it, leaving behind an altered region. This region can later be read out by causing it to emit light with yet another laser, and that can then be detected. So to write, you locally change the property of the material with lasers. To read, you cause it to emit light. The other advancement that they make use of is that this 2-laser method also allows them to encode structures below the wavelength of the lasers. This also makes it possible to pack the data more densely. I guess it also helps that they were working with a femtosecond laser that prevents them from melting the entire disk to a pool of goo before they're done working with it. Writing to and reading data from the disk actually works very nicely, as you can see in this video. What you can see here is a scan through the layers. They have alternatingly encoded the acronyms of their institute and the university, and you can see that they are pretty clearly readable. The distance between 2 layers is just about 1 micrometer, so you could pack 1,000 of them into a millimeter. That said, there is some way to go from there to commercialization. First and most importantly, when it comes to storing data, it's not just the density of the storage that matters, it also matters how quickly you can write the data and read it out. They didn't say anything about that, but I assume since this is a prototype, it's fairly slow. Then there's the question how much energy that takes, and also, where do you get a femtosecond laser from? Then again, you know, this entire area of technology is currently evolving so quickly. These challenges might be possible to overcome given a few years' time. So who knows, maybe compact discs will make a comeback in the not too far future. And inevitably the day will come when we'll all record our entire life in 8K. I can't wait for it. Watching science videos is all well and fine, and I don't mean to complain you're doing it, but it's not a good way to actually learn something new. If you want to learn something new, you need to actively engage with the topic. A free and easy way to do this is on Brilliant.org, who've been sponsoring this video. On Brilliant, you find courses on a large variety of topics in science, computer science, and mathematics. It's a fresh and new approach to learning that makes growing your knowledge easy and fun. I've learned so much there. All their courses come with interactive visualizations and follow-up questions. Some also have videos for demonstration experiments or executable Python scripts. This really gives you a feeling for what's going on, whether you want to know more about solar panels, neural networks, astrophysics, special relativity, or computational biology, Brilliant has you covered. I even have my own course there, that's an introduction to quantum mechanics. It's a beginner's course and covers topics such as interference, superpositions and entanglement, the uncertainty principle, and Bell's theorem. And after that, you can continue learning more about quantum objects or maybe quantum computing. To give it a try yourself, use our link brilliant.org/Sabine and sign up for free. You'll get access to everything Brilliant has to offer for 30 days, and the first 200 subscribers using this link will also get 20% off the annual premium subscription. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.